ටවුන් එකේ විෂංකයාකට ගියා නම් ඉවරයිනේ.
විෂංකයා විශ්වාසනීය දැක්ම.
The post 19th Amendment President exercises not merely ceremonial but a real executive power. There are inconsistencies and anomalies and all the rest of it, but that's a different matter. I don't think anyone with any sense would argue that President Sirisena is devoid of any power, substantive power whatsoever. That was the original idea of the 19th Amendment, but that is not what happened. If that old clause, the advice clause, that the president must always act upon the advice of the prime minister was introduced, that was the original scheme of the 19th Amendment legislation, then the matter was different. But that is not what happened. And the Supreme Court ensured that even the published bill was consistent with the 1917 constitution. So it remains a semi-presidential classic. The only change that it did basically was to reintroduce some of the democratic controls that we had in the pre-18th Amendment constitution back into our scheme. So it's sort of recalibrated, rebalanced our system a little bit better than this skewed and extremely distorted presidential system that we had under the 18th Amendment. That is all it did.
Dr. Welikala also added that majoritarian politics within our political culture is not the best choice for ethnic and religious minorities.
There are also, of course, occasions in which what the people want and what the public good of the country are two different things. Because what the people want are usually determined by majoritarian politics. And a political culture like ours, that may not be a good idea for a lot of things, including ethnic and religious minorities. I would be therefore, in that sense, a little hesitant to reify the people's will as a major determinant of what constitutional interpretation should do.